Symphony is a music social networking app. Just like Instagram revolutionized photo sharing globally, we are on a mission to revolutionize music sharing. Now, let me introduce you to one of our fictional characters. Let's call him Sam. Now, Sam is a student and he loves music. He was listening to this song, Hey Junoon, by KK, and he was simply fascinated by it. He wanted to share it with his friends. But when he went to do that, he found out that all his friends use different music streaming apps. One uses Saavn, other one uses Gaana, some uses Play Music, Apple Music, Spotify, Deezer, Wink, Jio Music, and the list goes on. Now this guy is now on his spot. He wants to share the song with his friends, but he does not have a unified platform to share music with his friends. And now Sam is disappointed. But out of the blue, one of his old school friends refers him this music social networking app called Symphony, which he downloads, searches a song out of more than 45 million songs, and shares the songs with his friends. Now, let's see how he does that. He shares 30-second music stories out of 45 million songs. Now, when he does that, all his friends, no matter which music streaming app they use, could listen to the song. They could like it, they could comment on it, they could bookmark it. They could also share the song on the app itself or with their friends. Now let's see how you could swipe through music stories on Symphony. So these are the songs shared by his friends that show up on his feed. The best part about it is, if you like the song, you could watch the entire YouTube music video on the app itself. So that is another feature that's added. So now, how many of us feel that music expresses emotions, but words simply fail? Oh, wow, great. Lots of hands. So we genuinely feel that this mode of expression needs a platform. And Symphony is on a mission to be that platform where music transcends all barriers and you can express through music. So this is how one of our music stories shared by one of our users looks like. You can use music stickers, you can write what you want to. And the best part about it is we have more than 45 million songs. Any genre, any language, anything, you could share that song on Symphony. So now, cut to 3 months, Sam has his exams. And he's a computer engineer. So he wants some music to listen while he's coding. So he wants to ask his friends or people around the globe, and he has two options. He can go to Quora, or he could go to Symphony. When he goes to Quora, he finds out this. This is a music recommendation on Quora. It's a music recommendation, but this recommendation is textual, and textual is boring. So now what he does, he goes to Symphony and asks the same question. It's like a dedicated music Q&A forum we have, where you can get answers which you could actually listen to and not only read. And that is how we want to build a global music community around this, where people can ask and answer music questions and you could actually listen to them. So let's see how it looks like. So that is kind of the dedicated music Q&A forum we have. Like, we call it the Quora for music. Moving on, we have worked hard on this product for more than 1.5 years now, and we felt that we all have predefined playlists on our music streaming apps. Like, we have a playlist for romantic songs, we have a playlist for workout songs, but what about if you wake up one morning and you want to listen to songs that really motivates you, or you want to go for a run, or something very specific to your real-time need? What if you had a personal DJ to yourself who talks to you and recommends you a song based on that? Well, we have built that, presenting to you our AI-enabled personal music assistant called Beat. Be it suggest you song based on your real-time needs, be it the time you are in, be it the activity you are pursuing, be it the genre you want to listen to, be it if you want to explore trivia or jokes of all kinds on the app. So that is how it looks like. Let's show a small demo of how it actually works. So here comes the list of songs, and you could actually listen to them right there. Okay, so moving on, that's our AI-enabled personal music assistant. We call it Beat. And the future scope for this bot is, it's at a nascent stage for us right now. We want to build this so specific, like if you ask, I want to listen to songs that have a very good guitar strumming music, or a song that has a very good violin around it. That is something even Google would struggle to give you, but we want to build that technology around this bot, which talks to you and suggests you music that you exactly want to hear. So we have a lot of standalone features in this. Like you could play daily music quizzes on our app. So this is how we have leaderboards where you can compete with people around the globe. We kind of try to gamify this music experience so that people have a more innovative, more better experience on the app. So this is how the music quiz looks like. So. So we have Bollywood music, we have global music quizzes, and this is like a poll of things that people have answered, like the colors show how many people have answered what. So that is kind of the, and you can also go and personally chat and share songs with your friends. So you could go personally share a song with your friend you would love to. You can use the music stickers. So just like Sam, there are more than 1 billion music streaming users globally. And we at Symphony are here to disrupt this $9 billion market. Now that was the revenue, music streaming revenue of 2018. Talking about how we make money. So just like any social media app, we look forward to making money at advertising revenue model that I would like to follow. Following up with that, we also want to have sponsored music stories on our app itself, like movies that come up recently. Artists who want to promote their songs on Symphony can pay us a fee for which we can sponsor. We can kind of show their posts up the feed, kind of advertise them. We also have a platform called Symphony Discover that's like something we feel that even upcoming artists deserve a chance to get the exposure. And we also promote that on our app. You can go to our website, you can fill in your song, and you can submit your 30-second song previews, your YouTube videos, and we will give you exposure. Right now it is free because we want to be kind of, we want to get in touch with the music community as such, but this can be a source of revenue when a fee can be charged. Moreover, we also have a feature called Music Match Pro, which I'll be talking about in the later slides. That will help us, that's like an in-app purchase that'll help you to get premium features around this app. So let's move on. So talking about the team, so I'm Roshan Albera. I'm a computer graduate, and I've been developing apps for like 3 to 4 years now. I'm a digital marketer as well. So I've interned at more than 5 companies. I've interned at IIM Ahmedabad, I've interned at Procter & Gamble, and it has been a good journey till now. We have had more than 15 interns since our inception, and that's about the team. So one of the best features about our app is we have one of the highest rated apps on the Play Store. Our average rating is 4.9 out of 5. And if we have more than 250 five-star reviews, the ratings have been overwhelming. People love the idea. Talking about the competitive landscape, so competitive landscape includes apps like social media elements of apps like Spotify. But the problem for them is the user base is fragmented, right, as we talked in the beginning. And in the concern of time, I'll just move ahead a little faster. Just making sure that Symphony does not compete with music streaming apps. But we want to be a first mover in the music sharing landscape. We don't want to compete with music streaming apps. Metrics, we have more than 12,000 installs. We are in more than 100 plus countries. And we are going fast. We are going ahead with a good rate. Talking about our achievements, one of our greatest achievements is we were selected for the finalists for the Rice Business Plan competition. Thanks to Thai that we are getting a full sponsored trip to the US for this. We also have won 2 national level competitions already. We are also also invited to Startup Grind and Collision Course. That's a conference in Silicon Valley and in Canada. We're also selected in the top 35 out of 300 international founders. We're also one of the finalist team members in the 10 Minute Million of IIT Bombay that was conducted. We're like top 10 out of 450 startups. The best part of our Symphony is we have 0 licensing costs. That's because we are part of the iTunes affiliate program and the YouTube API. So the demand is real. People love the app and they want an iOS version soon. You can see the screenshot that shows about the same. Now, our growth hacking strategy is we have a music match feature where users can, where we connect you to people across the globe with similar music tastes as yours. So you could get connected with people across the globe with similar music tastes. And that is the best part. Like, you're sitting here, you can get connected with somebody in the US who has a similar music taste. You can follow them, you can listen to them. And that's like a pro feature we can include here. So I promise you Symphony will become the norm. There's a problem, we have a solution, we have traction, and we have a beautiful product. So I would love you all to join us in this music revolution. Thank you so much for your time. Thank you.
Over to the jury.
Are you a student?
I just graduated recently.
Okay. Maybe you may have covered this. It wasn't clear to me.
Yeah.
So folks who are listening to different music streams can share via your app? How does that work? Let's say if I'm on Spotify right. or Pandora or some other app, So how do we share it on your app?
That's true. So we are part of the iTunes affiliate program. So we had applied for the iTunes affiliate program for which they open up their API, which has more than 45 million songs. So irrespective of the app you use, it doesn't matter. You can come to our product. It's like a standalone product where you can come and you can search for the song which you desire to share and you will get a song result and you can share it with your friends. That is how it is happening. So we are part of the iTunes affiliate program, and this is something that is used by very big startups like big start companies like Shazam and SoundHound. That's a model that they use too. So that is kind of the answer to the question.
Can you go to your traction slide?
Yes.
That was quick. Your traction slide.
Yes.
Can you go back to that?
Yeah, sure.
So basically, in your case, the killer app is the ability to share choices and sort of come together socially on that.
Yes.
So and what I'm hearing is, I'm not myself very educated in music streaming. My kids are, I'm sure. But what I'm trying to understand is that the existing sort of very successful apps with millions of users
yes.
Have this as a gap in their functionality. Am I hearing?
Yes.
Right?
So if you see apps like very big apps, like the biggest app in the world, Spotify, right now.
Yeah.
If you see, you cannot actually go there and share a music story where which you can express yourself, where people can come and like it, comment on it, or bookmark it. Those stuff doesn't exist. You can only follow your friends' playlists, and that is kind of, the social connect is missing. So that is one thing we want to solve. Second thing is Spotify has like maybe 20% of the world's market share right now, but there are still 80%, there are more than 25 plus music streaming apps that have 10 million plus users. So this area is extremely fragmented, and we want to be that unified platform where people use whichever music streaming app, they can come to our platform and share music.
Okay. And what's the catch there? So when we come through Symphony,
yes.
is it like there's a short 30-second availability of the song? I mean, what's different?
Yeah, the difference is like the music stories are 30 seconds in length.
Okay.
So you listen to, and that is good in one sense. That's like really good in one sense because in 1 minute, you could go through a lot of music stories. If I start a song that's a 3 minute song and you started listening to it, you could explore very little songs in a lot of amount of time. But when it comes to 30 second music stories, it's much more efficient. And then you could also watch the YouTube music video, the entire video if you want, if you like that song. Plus, we are in the process of integrating Spotify and Apple Music in the app itself. So now you can stream the entire song on the app on Symphony itself. So that is something we are in the process. Also, one thing I forgot to mention is we are also going to start with our revenue generation pretty soon because we have seen our retention rates and the overwhelming response that we are getting. So we'll be starting with a revenue model which we'll be using to grow our app further. Yep.
Okay. Yeah. One last question. So apart from your byline, if I were to ask you to describe what you do in 2 lines, how would you describe it?
Okay, so apart from the?
Apart from the byline, the social music streaming app, right? That's what you use as a byline.
The music
there.
Social networking.
Yeah, yeah, but apart from that, if I were to ask you to describe your business in 2 lines,
okay.
What would you say?
So basically, Symphony is like an Instagram and Quora for music, where users can share music stories out of 45 million songs, and we are here to build a global music community.
Okay. Thanks.
Yes.
Build friendship through music.
Yeah, didn't get you, sorry.
Build friendship through music.
Yeah, that's right. Even better. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Yuri.
Thank you so much.
And investor panel, anything? Oh, great. Thank you. Great show. Anybody else?
Thank you.
Thank you.
What are you raising? I didn't hear any of that. Yes. Are you raising?
Yeah, we are looking to raise around 50 lakhs for now, which will give us a marketing push and also increase our iOS app development. So till now, we had been bootstrapped totally.
And how many users can you get to with that 50 lakhs?
50 lakhs, we can get around 100,000 users.